We're going to take a look at Novadax tamoxifen citrate. It is a serum, a selective estrogen receptor modulator, a class of anti-estrogen that is used in bodybuilding by a lot of bodybuilders. It's one of the first ones that was used in bodybuilding. I think it might have been the first one. But anyway, we're going to dig into the nuts and bolts of it, how it works, how it's applied, etc. Before I do that, though, I get a lot of people watching my videos, not a lot of people subscribing. So I'd really appreciate it if you subscribed. It motivates me to make more of these videos. I plan on keep on making them anyway, but hopefully you find this information helpful. If you do, subscribe. It helps me out. Takes 1 second of your time and like the video. Feel free to comment too if you have questions. I can help with. I'm happy to answer your questions too. I return the favor to you, and share with friends if you find my information helpful. Anyway, all right, let's dig into this. So Novadax properties of Novadax. It is a oral non-steroidal anti-estrogen drug. As I mentioned at the beginning, it is a selective estrogen receptor modulator, commonly known as a SERM. I want to dispel this bro myth right now. All bros seem to lump all antiestrogens into the same category. It is not an aromatase inhibitor like letrozole or anastrozole. It's not. It's completely different. What it does is selectively blocks the estrogen from attaching to the receptor in estrogen receptor in breast tissue. It is what's really cool about it is the selective part of it. I mentioned that it attaches to breast tissue, but it is both an agonist and antagonist. But so in the liver, it actually acts as an estrogen, and as a result, causes improvement in cholesterol levels. Cool thing. It improves your good cholesterol. It was originally developed as a breast cancer treatment drug, as all these anti-estrogen drugs were for the most part. It was first made in 1962. Was initially tested as a fertility drug. It does stimulate the H hypothalamus pituitary axis. And in 1977, it was tested and approved as a breast cancer treatment drug. So it's been around for a while. I don't quote me on this, but I recall it first being used in the bodybuilding in sometime during the 80s. Effects of Novadax. It blocks estrogen in the breast tissue. Why is this important? Because that's what causes gyno to happen a lot of times. Estrogen-related gyno is from the estrogen attaching to the gland in the breast and causing growth. So it reduces estrogen-stimulated breast tissue growth. Used in conjunction with aromatase inhibitor. Studies have shown that it causes a regression in breast growth. So, this is for cancer treatment, but it also works on gyno if you catch it early. I'm talking about like pea-sized nubs or smaller, maybe as big as a marble. Usually at that point it's too late. But if you catch gyno early, you use Novadax in conjunction with a strong aromatase inhibitor. Usually, letrozole is the one that works the best in my experience. You can shrink that gyno back up. As I mentioned earlier, it stimulates the liver to produce good cholesterol HDL, which is really freaking cool. It also increases FSH and LH. Mentioned that as well through the hypothalamus pituitary axis. Side effects of Novadax: hot flashes, upset stomach, lightheadedness, edema can bloat you up, hair loss, lowered red blood cells count. I never really knew about that until I researched this, so maybe it can help counteract People that have hematocrit issues, I generally use Novodex and I've never had major hematocrit issues. Maybe that's why. I thought maybe it was just something genetically with me that I don't get hematocrit issues. Maybe it's the Novodex. I don't know. Blurred vision. I never really have a lot of side effects with it, but bodybuilding uses for Novodex. Obviously used to combat gyno without crushing estrogen. That is a good point. In the off season when we're bulking, estrogen is good for building size. It also is good for our health, our cardiovascular health, our neurological health. So if we can keep estrogen under management while using aromatizing steroids by just using Novodex, we're probably better off for it health-wise. Your cardiovascular health is going to be better. Your neurological health is going to be better. Anti-estrogens are pretty rough. Now, keep in mind, this is also a good application for steroids that don't aromatize but do interact with the estrogen receptor. An example would be Anadrol. So, first time I got it was from Anadrol, and Anadrol does not aromatize. And I hear a lot of knuckleheads taking aromatase inhibitors to help with it. Not going to do shit. This, in theory, should help. It improves your lipids. It actually makes your cholesterol better. Potentially lower your red blood cell count. Helps with that hematocrit thing. And it's also good for hardening up the chest region in contest prep. I definitely have noticed that it tightens the chest up. Novodex half-life, 12 hours. Ideally, you should be dosing it twice per day. I'm guilty of not doing that, but should be dosed twice per day. Doses that I see, I hate beginner, intermediate, advanced. Really, it depends on how strong your estrogen-related issues are. As with all things, you want to use the least amount possible. This is all about harm reduction for me. And the best way to reduce harm is to use less drugs. Use no drugs is even better. Beginner, probably 10 milligrams per day is about the lowest dose, your effective dose. Intermediate, 20 milligrams per day. That's typically where I use it at. Sometimes I do 10. Get away with 10, but 20 seems to be pretty effective. 30 milligrams a day, like if you got a really bad case of gyno, that you might want to push it up to that. My experience, I really have not noticed any side effects from it. It doesn't cause me any issues. My estrogen, as I've mentioned in other videos, runs really high. Novodex alone, for me, when running heavily aromatizable steroids. Is that even a word, aromatizable? Steroids that aromatize heavily? How about that? It hasn't been enough for me to stop gyno. I've got to use it in conjunction with a AI. I can get away with a small dosage. It definitely helps tighten my chest up on contest prep. I had some fat and looseness around my chest, going into this last contest, and as soon as I added Novodex in and up my anti-estrogens, it tightened right up. And as I mentioned before, I typically run 20 milligrams per day. That seems to be ample for me. I think that's the therapeutic dose. Don't quote me on that. Thank you for watching my video. I really appreciate it. Really appreciate everybody that's been subscribing and watching my videos. I'm really trying to put up videos that I would have found helpful when I was learning about this stuff. If you appreciate my videos, please like and subscribe. I know I keep beating that in the ground. Feel free to ask questions. If you have any questions, I'm happy to answer questions. That's why I'm doing this, to help people out. If there are any other videos on PEDs you would like me to make, let me know. I'm happy to take suggestions or requests. And follow me on Instagram if you want to keep updated on upcoming videos and what's going on with me. My Instagram is Paul K. Barnett. Have a great day.